Okay, thank you. So, hi everybody, and thanks to the organizers for giving me the opportunity to present my work, which is about galactic chemical evolution models, and I will present results from lithium up to europium. So a brief outline of my presentation, I will start with a brief introduction, then I will present the chemical evolution models considered. Then I will show the results, first for the alpha elements, where it is clear the dichotomy between the thick and thin disk. And then I will apply the models to the study of other chemical elements, such as lithium and neutron capture elements. Finally, I will give you a summary and wrap up the conclusions. So a brief introduction, we are really in a golden era for galactic archaeology thanks to the advent of large spectroscopic galactic surveys such as in Deep Gala. And in this way, the tail stellar abundances of stars in the Milky Way can be measured. Then by means of detailed chemical evolution models, it is also possible to predict the chemical abundances expected in stars of each galactic component. As we know, the Milky Way has four main stellar populations that differ on the basis of chemical and kinematical criteria, such as halo stars, bulge stars, thick and thin disk stars. And in my talk, I will mainly focus on the thick and thin disk chemical evolution. So the observational data from which I've started are the Ambre data that show that in the abundance patterns of the alpha elements, such as magnesium, there are two distinct sequences corresponding to thick and thin disk stars, and also a further metal-rich high alpha population. So here I show the observed magnesium over iron versus phi over H from Ambre, color coding in red for thick disk stars, in gray for thin disk stars. And we can see that the thick disk is generally alpha enhanced. This means that it should have formed faster on a shorter time scale of formation with respect to the thin disk. And we can also see another population color coding separately in blue, the metal rich high alpha stars that still needs to be well understood by chemical evolution models. So chemical evolution models, in our paper, we adopted two different chemical evolution approaches, a revised twin fold approach that we applied only to the thick and thin disks. In this scenario, we assumed that the galactic disk formed by means of two infall episodes, the first one giving rise to the thick disk and the second one giving rise to the thin disk on a longer time scale of formation. On the other hand, we also consider a parallel approach where the thin and thick disk start forming at the same time but evolves at different rates. To start, I will start by showing the star formation histories for the two different approaches. So on the left for the two infall model and on the right for the parallel one. In the twin fold model, which is a sequential scenario, we have a first phase corresponding to the thick disk formation. Then there is a gap due to the assumed threshold in the star formation process. And then the thin disk start forming on a longer time scale of formation until reaching the present day star formation rate. On the other hand, in the parallel approach, we have two distinct tracks corresponding to the thick and thin disk evolution. But also in this case, the thick disk form faster, and so its star formation rate is peaked toward earlier ages with respect to the thin disk, which evolves slowly on a longer time scale of formation. Given these star formation histories, what happens in the abundance patterns? So here I show the magnesium over iron versus phi over H observed by Ambre and also predicted by the two infall model in the upper panel and by the parallel model in the lower one. What we can see is that in the two infall model, which as I said is a sequential scenario, we have the first phase corresponding to thick disk formation that matches the thick disk data in red. Then we have this gap due to the assumed threshold in the star formation process. And then the thin disk starts forming on a longer time scale of formation, matching the thin disk data in gray. On the other hand, in the parallel approach, we have two distinct tracks corresponding to the thick and thin disk, and the thick disk is alpha enhanced with respect to the thin disk due to the shorter time scale of formation and higher star formation efficiency. And with the thick disk model, we can also match the metal-rich alpha enhanced stars that in this scenario can be interpreted as metal-rich thick disk stars. On the other hand, in the twin fold model, the only way to explain the metal-rich alpha enhanced star is by assuming radial migration from the inner regions of the Milky Way. As final constraint, we consider the metallicity distribution function. So here I show the observed and predicted MDF by the twin fold model in the upper panels and by the parallel model in the lower ones. So in the case of the twinfold model, we can explain the MDF of the thick disk and the one of the thin disk, but not the metal-rich Alpha-Nansen stars that, as I said, the only way to explain them is by assuming radial migration from the inner regions of the Milky Way. In the case of the parallel model, instead, we can explain the whole thick plus metal-rich Alpha-Nansen MDF. So we can interpret these metal-rich Alpha-Nansen stars simply as metal-rich thick disk stars. Okay, after the study of the alpha elements, we applied our models. In particular, I focus on the parallel model that enable us to follow separately the evolution of the thick and thin disk, also to the study of other chemical elements. And I will start now with lithium, and I will refer also to other talks that have done a nice overview about lithium, such as the previous talk by Laura Magrini and the next one by Donatella Romano and many others. So recently, many spectroscopic surveys, such as AMBRE and Gaia-ESO, show a clear dichotomy between the thick and thin disk also in the lithium plot, and an evident ISM lithium decline at the high metallicities that, however, is still a matter of debate. This feature, if real, still needs to be well understood in terms of galactic chemical evolution models, and some possible explanation have been proposed in the literature, such as lower yields of lithium from single star at the high metallicities or radial migration. But we propose a novel explanation for this behavior and this decline. So here I show the results for the model of the thin disk, considering the various lithium sources, all the sources, the concentration, only AGB, only galactic cosmic rays, and only novae. And as we can see, most of lithium is produced by novae, which are the main lithium producer in the galaxy. By applying this prescription to both the model of the thick and thin disk, we can get a dichotomy in the lithium plot. And I compare the model prediction for the thick and thin disk also with data from Gaia-ESO survey on the left and AMBRE data on the right. And in particular, AMBRE data follow the upper envelope, that it is what we want to explain, since lithium is very easily destroyed. So we can get a dichotomy in the lithium plot with the thin disk being lithium enhanced with respect to the thick disk that evolve faster. So the reverse knee in the case of the thick disk, it shifted to our iron metallicities in agreement with the data. In the case of the thin disk, we have the plateau, the rise, we match the meteoritic value, but then our model continue to rise at variance with the data that seems to decline. So we try to explain this decline and propose a novel explanation. We say, okay, if novae are the main lithium producers in the galaxy, what happens if the fraction of binary system giving rise to novae decline with metallicity? So we test this hypothesis and we can get a flattening of the curve bending at the high metallicity. So proposing a novel explanation for this decline at the high metallicities. Okay, after lithium, we also applied the parallel model to neutron capture elements, and we know that elements beyond the iron peak, as also explained by Chuck in the previous talk, are mainly formed to neutron capture and heavy seed nuclei, and there are two possible cases, the S process or the R process. In the case of the S process, the main production sites are suggested to be low mass AGB stars, but also massive star can produce some neutron capture elements via S process. On the other hand, in the case of the air process, an extremely neutron-rich environment is required, and in literature, several production sites have been proposed, such as core collapse supernovae, electron capture supernovae, magneto-rotationally driven supernovae, and finally neutron star mergers that are included in our chemical evolution models. So the observational data that we wanted to consider and interpret in this case are the one by Forsberg et al. That distinguish between thick and thin disk and also bulge for chemical elements such as zirconium, lanthanum, cerium, and europium. I will start by showing the results for europium. So here I show the europium over iron versus phi over H observed by Forsberg and compared with our parallel model for the thick and thin disk, but also the bulge model of Matteucci et al. That assume an even faster formation and shorter time scale of formation with respect to the thick and thin disk. So we can nicely see that we both observe and predict distinct sequences in such a plot, with the bulge being over-enhanced with respect to the thick disk and the thin disk. And the track of the bulge is shifted to a higher metallicity due to its faster formation and shorter time scale of formation, in agreement with the time delay model. So if we apply our models instead to the S process element and to zirconium, lanthanum, cerium, we can see that in this case, however, the population are more mixed and it's more difficult to disentangle between them, but still we can interpret the overall behavior in terms of a time delay model with the budget that evolved faster as a track shifted to a higher metallicity with respect to the other components. So I've reached my conclusion, give you a summary. We started by adopting two different approaches to study the evolution of the galactic thick and thin disks, a twin fold approach and a parallel approach. We applied our models, in particular the parallel model, to the study of other chemical elements such as lithium, and we can see a dichotomy between thick and thin disks also in the lithium plot. And we also propose a novel explanation for the ISM lithium decline at the high metallicity as due to a lower fraction of binary system giving rise to novae, which are the main lithium producer in the galaxy. Then we also applied our model to the study of neutron capture elements and the europium over iron versus phi over H diagram. We observe and predict three distinct sequences corresponding to thick disk, thin disk, and bulge, similarly to what happens for the alpha elements. On the other hand, in the case of zirconium, lanthanum, and cerium, the three populations are more mixed, and also from the model point of view, it's more difficult to disentangle between them, but still we can interpret the overall behavior in terms of the so-called time delay model with population forming much faster, such as the bulge being shifted to a higher metallicity in agreement with the time delay model. So I conclude here and welcome your questions. Thank you.
All right, thank you very much. Ria, that's very interesting work to see. I would be happy to have anybody use the raise hand reaction to let me know you have questions, or you can type them in the chat if you would rather. Oh, Corinne has a question. Go ahead.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you, Valeria. I have a point about lithium. You probably, you mentioned the paper of 2021, where actually we selected hot stars, because in Ambre, the stars that are observed are only cool stars. And in these cool stars, we expect lithium depletion. So, but if you look in Gala, and actually if you look at Gala stars with the same temperature, you find the same behavior. But in Gala, you also have access to hotter stars that might preserve lithium. And in that case, you see an increase that you predict. So I don't know if Donatella will talk about that, but it would support your models with a lithium increase, actually.
Okay, thank you for the comments. Yeah, indeed, the models predicts a rise and don't see a decline at the high metallicity. But since the data at the time shown that decline, we tried to propose a novel explanation that was related to novae production. So
yeah, but I think it's really due. Well, my point of view is that it's really due to depletion of lithium inside the stars you're looking at, and not to the depletion in the ISM.
Okay, thank you very much, because yeah, it's something that really interests me. Thanks.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Very good. In the chat, Sanjeev Sharma has asked about your parallel model. If you can form the thin and thick disk at the same time and the same location, or at the same time but in different locations.
Okay. Sorry, in the parallel model, can thick and thin disks fall at the same time, at the same location, same time, but different? Okay, yeah, I show the prediction at the same location, so in the solar vicinity, so the results. But we also extended the parallel models to the various galactocentric distances in another paper, 2018, that, well, I didn't show the results about that, but we also study the evolution at different locations. But here I mainly focus on the dichotomy in the solar vicinity.